I wanted to be a Marine. Those dress blues just knocked me out. Unfortunately, it was segregated. But as soon as President Roosevelt gave an executive order that anyone could join the Marines, I was the first Mississippian African American to be sworn in. They were building a separate camp in North Carolina for blacks. It was Montfort Point Camp, which was part of Camp Lejeune, North Carolina. Once we got there, we were trained by veteran white Marines who had fought on Guadalcanal. At first, they were determined to give us hell to show Roosevelt that Negroes ain't tough enough to be Marines. But we were just as determined. Like black Marines everywhere else, we were segregated from day one. We wound up on Iwo Jima. For 3 weeks straight, black Marines in my company worked and fought. One of the bravest sights I've seen was on Iwo, where a black driver of a duck truck time and time again delivered much-needed ammunition to Marines fighting at the foot of Suripachi. Japanese shot two trucks out from under him, but he came back every time. That's when they started to realize that we were just as good as everybody else, and our bullets hit just as true. It was the first time you felt like you were part of the whole and not left out of anything. You didn't feel second-handed. And you didn't feel like a slave. You felt like you were an American citizen.